shadow work. Shadow work is pretty deep. It's very hard, and a lot of people don't like to do it, and it's actually still considered taboo. Our shadow side is the side that we choose not to focus on. So personally, as a shadow coach, I believe it is important to love all of yourself, not just 50%. We have light, we have beauty, we have smiles and laughter and all the positive stuff, but there's also stresses and anxieties and emotions and all these things and tears and all these things that we don't want to deal with. And we see them as negative and we want to push them away. So what shadow work does is taking your shadow, bringing it to the surface, and then just accepting it all, deal with it, owning all of you, and then when you start to love all of you, then you love everybody else because you no longer project your feelings onto others. You stop judging yourself. If you can stop judging you for all the feelings that you don't want to feel, you'll be able to stop judging others. So there's the sun and the moon, day and night, yin and yang, and all this is needed. The sun and the moon are just as important. We don't just push away at night. It's not important and it's not good. So I'll give you guys an example of what shadow work is. Let's say, for example, you slice your arm open, right? So it's bleeding, it's hurting, you slice it open. The normal thing would be to take care of it. But if we apply what we apply to our emotions of saying push it away, imagine yourself ignoring it, pushing it aside and not dealing with it. What would happen to your arm? Well, it would hurt. It wouldn't really heal because you're not taking care of it. It'd probably get infected, so you'd either need antibiotics or eventually have to amputate your arm. So imagine we did this with emotions. Imagine we took care of our emotions instead of pushing them away. So what happens when you push away a negative emotion, let's say sadness, and you don't want to feel it and you don't want to feel hurt and pain? It festers just like the wound and it gets infected. And how it comes out, because it always comes out, you're going to have to deal with it eventually, is you either lash out at someone, you lose relationships, you lose your job, you lose things, and all of a sudden your life is all over the place and nothing seems right because everything is unbalanced. And then either you have to cut a person off, you lose something just like you would lose your arm if you don't take care of it. So shadow work is taking care of the negative, having compassion for yourself. Also, what it's good for is when you have compassion for yourself, let's say you have trauma from your past. You take that trauma, you bring it to the surface, and you learn to deal with it, and you understand it. So that's the steps, because first you bring it to the surface. You become aware of it, and you become aware of your feelings. What is this making me feel? So you identify your feeling, and then once you identify it, you're able to recognize it in yourself if it comes now. Let's say, for example, if you're somebody who was abandoned as a child and your parents didn't pay attention to you and you felt abandoned, then in your future, you're going to start feeling abandoned with friends and relationships. So now you can recognize it because it's at the surface. You can actually look at it. So once you start to deal with them, there's a weird emotion that develops that's called gratitude. So you go, wait a minute, I'm feeling this, I recognize it, and now you say, wait a minute, it's there for a reason. So let's say you take these negative emotions and they're coming at you. So let's say they're beach balls. Every beach ball represents a negative emotion and you're swimming in a pool. A beach ball comes in and let's say you got a ticket because you were just in a really good mood and everything was going well. And you might have been speeding, okay? Because you were listening to a song, you were going a little faster, and you got an unexpected ticket. But you don't want to deal with that negative emotion because it's not acceptable. So what do? You take that beach ball and you put it underwater. And then something else happens. You wake up in the morning and you didn't have the cup of coffee or it was bitter or whatever. And then somebody snapped at you at work. And all of a sudden you're like, I'm not going to deal with this. I'm going to be better and higher. I'm only going to focus on the positives. You take that beach ball and you put it in. When you're younger, it's easy to hold a bunch of beach balls underwater and float on them. But as you get older, as you get tired throughout the day, in the evening, what happens when you have 5, 6 beach balls and you're pushing them underwater? Eventually, they come flying out of the water. What happens? This is the same thing with life. If we keep suppressing half of our feelings, our emotions that we see as bad. Okay? Negative emotions are just emotions that we see as bad. But negative is not bad. Negative is just opposite. Okay? The opposite of good. But it's not bad. Let me explain. So let's say all these balls and flying up and they hit you in the face, okay? And they're flying all over the place. That's exactly like your emotions. You could all of a sudden have everything under control, and all of a sudden, that cherry on top, something just hit you and you were not feeling good and you were tired that day, and you lash out at someone unexpectedly. Or you're this great, calm person, and all of a sudden, you're losing all your friendships. Your marriage is crumbling, but yet you are that positive person. The brighter the sun, the darker the shadow. And this applies to life. So if ever you see the sun is really shining and you look down, you have a really dark shadow, it's the same thing for our feelings. So if you just push all that positivity to the surface, that negativity is going to be somewhere. It has to go somewhere. So what's going to happen is it's going to come out unexpectedly and it's not going to be balanced. So what a shadow coach does is we help you find that balance. So first, as I mentioned before, you're going to recognize it, bring it to the surface. That's all shadow work. That is just emotional. A lot of psychologists do that. We just dig up all these traumas that you may have not have been aware of. You just become aware of them, because awareness is the number one key to happiness and inner peace. You just become aware of them. They're there, right? The second, as they become aware, you have to write down everything that you see, that what you went through, okay? Then as you reread it, I want you to not reread it and relive it. I want you to reread it. So at the end of the page, you write, "This is my perception." So whatever happened in your life, what you're feeling is your perception of what happened. If you lived trauma in your life, you created a feeling from that trauma. Somebody could have lived a similar trauma and had a different feeling. But you had your perception of it, created an emotional reality to it, and then now it happened, you can't change it, it's the past, but now you're taking it into your present. So if you learn to bring it to the surface, deal with it, understand it is your perception of what happened, your parents may have a different perception, your brothers and sisters may have a different perception, just understand that's your perception. And then know that it's okay that you felt all these things. It is super important to know that it is very okay. And all those emotions were needed for you to become the person you are today, okay? Once you get to that step and understand that all this is your perception, you are now the person you are today, you are going to go back and say, what has it taught me? What has all those things taught me? If it taught you to be bitter and resentful and all those things, it's because you took those emotions and you just dwelled in it. So finding the shadow is finding the balance of the positive and negative, not completely going into the negative and not completely going into the positive, finding your center. So if you find, what did it bring me? What did it teach me? And finding the gratitude. So you can do a gratitude journal. So you write, okay, today I'm grateful for this. If you can't find the gratitude in the past, find your gratitude in the present. So write a journal of every day what you're grateful for, running water, roof over your head, if you have a nice little pet, an animal, anything. It could be very small, it could be very big, whatever you can be grateful for. And then on another page, you write the things that you're grateful for. Let's say one of your parents took away love, withheld love. A lot of parents did do this in the past, and it was a normal thing back then, is that we have to stop the love for our kid to do a certain thing. So if a parent withheld love from you because you didn't act the way they wanted you to, you have to understand that right now you will be giving more love to your friends and family, and you will not withheld love. So it taught me love. It taught me unconditional love. So you have to take all those things, find out what it brought you, and then you become grateful. At the end, once you hit the gratitude level, okay, which can take months, it can take years, okay? So you have to be patient with yourself. But once you hit the gratitude level, all of a sudden then, you hit the full acceptance. You now, you'll start to shed tears, and when you're crying, it's not gonna be negative anymore. And when you're angry, you'll feel angry, you'll deal with it, it'll go away. You'll no longer be that unbalanced person that's all of a sudden way too positive or way too negative. You'll just find it. And then when you start to find it, you start to love yourself and you stop judging yourself because you understand that all of those emotions are needed. And then you stop judging others. So if you're somebody that you have a tendency to judge, let's say somebody that you feel that is overweight, you're noticing a lot of people are more overweight than usual, it's because you yourself are feeling overweight. So what happens is you start to recognize that everything is a mirror. So if you're feeling something, you're going to see it in another, because you cannot see in another person what you do not have. So remember that. If it's in your mind, it's because you have it, or there's a version of you that wishes you had it, or you admire it in somebody, but you kind of have it. So if you find somebody beautiful, there's a part of you that feels beautiful. If you find somebody overweight, negative, or this, anything you see in somebody else, you have. And then you're going to start to recognize it. Now, if you do shadow work and you work hard on yourself, picture that future for you, for your family. Picture the future for the whole world. If we did shadow work, we no longer feel the need to judge other people's decisions, other people's lives, because we understand that every single life that people have lived is for a reason. Their actions are there for a reason. And there is, I'm going to do another video on boundaries, because there is levels of boundaries, because a lot of people that don't do shadow work are not even close to accepting their shadow work. They have a lot of darkness in them and they put it on you. And then you'll notice, though, that you'll start distancing from them automatically, or you'll see them and you'll kind of just, you won't own what they say about you, because you'll know who you are inside. And you won't feel the need to judge them, but you will have a certain healthy boundary that you won't have to accept it in your life at all anymore. And eventually, they actually kind of naturally disappear into your life. So the people who don't, who constantly try to change you and to make you another person because they have not accepted their own shadows, those people will naturally drift away. And you'll notice it's just the cool energy of the world. It's just like, it's like you have your back. You learn to love all yourself, accept all of yourself. So it's kind of the universe, source energy, God, whatever we want to call it, now has your back and says, well, listen, since you love and accept all of you and you're taking care of you, I will take care of you. So this is a lot. It's a lot of work. And it's hard work and it's not easy, but those steps and meditation is a big deal. I'm going to say it in every video. Meditation is very important to bring that to the surface, because meditation does not bring super wellness and happiness. Meditation brings awareness. It brings everything to the surface. So if you just like brushing your teeth, you got to meditate every day for it to come to the surface. So I hope this helped. And, the dark side of the light chasers, how about we just accept all of ourselves completely? Have a great day.